is an online learning according to the International Association of K-12 Online Learning Initiative. It described that online learning itself normally have several characteristics. The first one is obviously the main reason or the main aims for the online learning itself is to enhance and expand educational opportunities. So we don't limit our learning process only inside of the classroom, but we can go beyond that through this online learning approach. And then the second one, it's obviously still teacher-led which we can do this online learning, especially leading by the teacher itself. And it may be synchronous or it can be real-time, face-to-face like we are doing now in the Zoom, or asynchronous approach, which is you record some video and then let students learn from the video. And also it can be accessed from multiple settings. It can be inside of the school building or from home. It can be using teleconferencing tools like Zoom or without that. The settings also, the environment for this online learning need to be communicated with teachers, with students, and also with parents as well. As I mentioned in our overview, we will talk about this technological pedagogical content knowledge. It is introduced by Dr. Judy Harris and Dr. Mark Hover. They are educators that dealing with this conceptual or theoretical idea of how technological can be integrated into a learning process. So if you see in this Venn diagram, as you are maybe already familiar with, that educators or teachers, they should have deep understanding about their content, either they are science teacher or physical teacher or the other subject. They need to know, understand their subject very well. And also in the other part, they also need to know how to deliver the lesson, either in the normal class in the school or when they're doing the online learning session. So we call them as the pedagogical knowledge. But for technological integration, the other important factor is technological knowledge. And if we see in this Venn diagram, when they are merged like this, we have this interlinked area that we call the technological pedagogical content knowledge, or TPACK. So in order to learn more, you can go to this website, TPACK.org. So this is another area that teachers nowadays need to understand well, how to integrate this technology into the learning process itself. So related with this approach from TPACK, as you can see here from the slide, I put this some learning activity types that normally we are doing, teachers doing in the normal condition in classroom. There are at least 20 types of learning activity. And this is also can be done using the technology integration, or you can do it in online learning, but we have limitation, as you mentioned before, like the time, the time for the online learning session itself. But this is 20 types of learning activity can be done using online learning. And I want your some ideas. You can type in Zoom chat, maybe which of these learning types activity that can be done using a online learning approach. To have some ideas about that one. All of them we can do it, or maybe some of them we can possibly doing while doing online learning. Okay, so let me check. Yeah, Okay, so this is normal condition in the classroom. You can do this learning activity, but also you can introduce in through the online learning activity. For example, in lab, instead of doing a real lab, or you can record the lab activity in the lab, in the school lab, or in your home. It is a small activity, and then you can give the students the idea of the lab activity, or obviously you can use virtual lab activity in order to give students a learning objective related with the subject or the topics. Yeah. Thank you from Mr. Akib. Students may record and upload themselves voice or video. It's very good to explain their understanding. Yeah, the other important factor for learning, normally we need evidence, whether the students learn or not. And this evidence can be given by students, or we can see the evidence from the assignment that is given, the reflection. Okay, I'll go to our next slide.